And welcome again, dear students. It's me, Shantanu Ghosh, with my third lecture on Aadhe Adhure by Mohan Rakesh. But before we go into this lecture, let's have a quick recap of what we have already discussed so far. The crisis of identity and breakdown of communication in human relations and resultant tragic effect of boredom and despair constitute the theme of Rakesh's play that we have already seen. But now what I propose to do in this discussion is that I am going to take certain passages, probably dialogues or instances, incidents from this play itself, so that we can come to some sort of conclusion later on regarding the art of Mohan Rakesh. The main characters of the play are being involved in self-made phenomenon of the soul's search for an alternative sanctuary. In the absence of the sanctuary of the home, which generally stands for a source of solace and moral stay to the individual in the moments of crisis. The search for identity in Aadhe Adhure is best articulated through the central character of Savitri. Why I said central character? Because the entire story revolves around her, and she is the center. Every character that we come across other than her is some way or the other attached to her, influenced by her. So Savitri seeks marital bliss even beyond conjugal relations in men who possess qualities she has always aspired for in her husband. Now be very attentive in what she is saying here, quote unquote. Why does one get married? In order to fulfill a need, an inner void, if you like, to be self-sufficient, complete. Mark this statement. Doesn't this statement express the kind of dilemma, the anxiety she is facing in her life? And mind you, the search is a tragic one for her, ridiculous, absurd, because it's futile. We see her very much influenced by Juneja, you know, who has power, affluence, a sense of, you know, reason. Again, another man in her life, Shivjit, intellectual prowess, his university degree, numerous trips abroad. Then Jagmohan, understanding nature, modernism, and a sense of humor. And Manoj, of course, who became her son-in-law later on. His influential status. This is Savitri for you. Let us move on to Mahendranath now. Mahendranath too is searching for a new identity and reason behind his existence. Though his relationship with Juneja, once he was a bread earner for the family, but now he is a non-entity. Can we extract something of his something from his statement, his helplessness, his, you know, sense of futility, quote unquote. Silent acceptance, perpetual snubs, constant insult, is all that I deserve after so many years? This is a piece of puzzle he is not able to solve. Both the children, Ashok and Binny, explore the dynamics of identity on their own worlds. Ashok, detached from reality, you know, seeking his identity in idleness, impulsivity, and of course romance. Kimi, on the other hand, searches her identity through her emerging adolescent sexuality, rebelliousness, and arrogance. Binny, the elder daughter of that family, take her instance, her elopement with Manoj, one of the, you know, if I may put it this way, lovers of her mother. That elopement is not in an impulse of love or romance, but in search of an abode away from home, seeking peace and protection. But the question is, did she get that? No. And how does she cope with that situation? Her reply is defiance. I'm using her statement here from the play itself. Talking about Manoj, she tells her mother, "He likes my hair long, so I want to cut it. He does not like me to work, so I want a job." Now, what does these instances signify? Number one, Savitri as a single working woman never explore the arena of identity as an individual woman, but defines herself in terms of fulfillment in various relations with different men. So perhaps Mohan Rakesh is raising questions about the status of women's autonomy, the status of women as an autonomous individual in the society. Number two, Mahendranath and Savitri are not finding meaning in their relationship, conjugal relationship, married life. Can this also be seen as a virtual breakdown of marriage as an institution? Number three, Manmohan loses his position in family as the breadwinner, as the earning member. And when the roles of the provider and the receiver are changed, the receiver becomes the provider and the provider becomes the receiver. This to me is, you know, in a way, kind of redefining terms of sex and gender in the society. And I find it very interesting. Dear students, Adhe Adhure portrays perhaps Mohan Rakesh's conviction of the failure of marriage during his time. Isn't it ironical that the Hindu Marriage Act came into force for the protection of the rights of Hindu women? in 1955. And the same era, the same time, you know, you see a man of the family is having a kind of monogamous relationship. He never thinks of getting out of it, but the women is verging onto a system called polygamy. It's not marriage, I understand, I agree. But there is constant, you know, betrayals on her part with the male members she, you know, usually meets and mixes up with. Now the important question, who is the culprit? Savitri, Mahendranath, or the circumstances? I think Mohan Rakesh has come up with a definite answer. Mohan Rakesh here becomes the interpreter of the maladies of the modern world, precluding a world where human life will become an ocean of uncertain incidents or happenings, purposelessness, futility, and disintegration of family system in the society. On a parting note, dear students, I would like you to remind you that you need to study a literary genius like Mohan Rakesh in his complete totality. The thematic exploits, the modernity, all becomes more important when you study him along with his worthy contemporaries like Kamleshwar, Rajendra Yadav, Nirmal Varma, Bhisham Sahni. And I would suggest you should devote some of your time to study the dominant trends during the time of Mohan Rakesh so as to fathom his genius. Because Mohan Rakesh to me is way, way ahead of his times. What we see in our society today, you know, the complications arising out of, you know, the working woman culture, where women are assuming their, you know, status, asserting their rights, and the male members are feeling helpless because the age-old precedents, traditions are not helping them at all. So they are in no man's land, and that is probably the cause for concern. And marriage as an institution, Mohan Rakesh asserted, it's not going to work in the future. I know it's frightening, but that is going to happen, and that is happening. So, thanks for your precious time. Thank you.